from in the industry, there are a lot of now producers of architects, you know. There are a lot of schools of architecture who are producing maybe 40, 50 students, you know. And then in the city, you have maybe 300 students every semester passing out, and they are in the market. And we are not able to develop corporate offices, corporate practices, and the practices which are very limited, you know, because of the economic situation and the sustainability in Pakistan, they are not able to sustain or grow out from their very limited, you know, shell. So there is a challenge of continuing the legacy of those established offices who have been a part of this profession like in the last two decades. So there is that experience and the continuation of experience for the young architects to get an opportunity to work with those architects is not seen now, and everyone gets more or less the projects, you know, maybe a shorter scale projects, and they start their own thing. It is a good that they get to establish very early, but they don't get that comprehension of practice which you can only get while working in the offices. It's a multidiscipline office, you know, like in Nespark or other big offices. So they are not expanding. I think that is the major challenge which I foresee. I think I admire Habib Fidali. I think he's one of the true modernists who have sustained up to, you know, this. Maybe he died, I think, a year back or so, if I'm correct. So, you know, a lot of our generation and your generation, they have actually seen the master of the modernism, you know, in our context. So I admire his work, and I think with so much of simplicity and minimalist effort, he created a lot of, you know, overwhelming statement of architecture. That's amazing. I think there's a lot of there's no standardization and a gauge, you know, how to select a material and how to select a contractor, and there is like the credibility issue of such people and vendors and products in our market. Everyone is selling everything, and they are getting, you know, they are traders, but they don't know the technicalities of the products. Everyone is getting material from Far East, from China, without knowing the specification and with just only the outlook of it. So the most of the clients actually fall prey to such gimmicks, you know. And then once they have, you know, invested and have applied all these materials, they come to know the reality and the, you know, of that material. So I think that is the issue. And also we have a lack of vocational training. There is no qualified mason or carpenter or plumber. There is no institute who actually produce these vocational people. So we need to, I think, invest more into that rather than making a lot every energy in making architects. I think we need to have technical people, you know, technologists, you know, who are neither specialized in architecture or are they are somewhere mediating between. This gap is, you know, vacant in our society. Absolutely positive, because we don't, there is a lot of debates, and I get to hear on TV and media, you know, that people are just very careful about it, and they are speculating that they will be ripped off from their own chunk out of the CPAC. I think there are new opportunities, and a lot of prosperity and new opportunities are coming. So everyone gets the share. You are bound to get your share. There is no such, I think, there should not be any fear about it. Everyone will be part of the success. I believe. I think the clarity of spaces. He isn't confused about anything. He just wanted to give such interest, and there is those, and his spaces are not that anticipated ones. You know, once you go into this one canal, 500 square yards, 50 by 90 conventional, so you get to know. You are expecting some very conventional things. There is a change in material or something, finishes maybe. But here, you know, there is a lot of interest. You get the, you know, out of surprises, there are many things to cherish. I think it's a wonderful idea. There is no doubt about it. And promoting architecture, build spaces, the persons behind the scenes, the client, I think it is a win-win situation for everyone. For the audience and for the client even, he gets the appreciation and acknowledgement from you know, random profile of people coming in, and a huge sort of acknowledgement for the architect. He gets this this comfort and gets this comfort and confidence. You know, it's the height of that. So it's a wonderful and commendable effort.